I love heart furniture. I love a heart tchotchke.
What if we had like a heart headboard?
That for the bed?
That would be really cute.
You thinking like a heart, like a...
Yes, like this, but like 20 times the size. Maybe like velvet. Velvet's such a sexy fabric. We might have to go custom on this because I don't know like where one can just buy a heart-shaped bed.
We need to do something with the ceiling. I don't know what it is yet, but there does need to be something, some moment up here. Because if we have this sexy bed and this like funky print.
We have to do something. I mean, we definitely need to paint it. I feel like I want to paint every ceiling.
You're in bed with your four lovers staring at the ceiling.
I love to customize everything, and this is such a special motel. I feel like I want it to be like incredibly unique and like everything one of a kind if we can.
Even if people walk in here blackout drunk with one eye open, they're like, oh, I know this is the Queen of Hearts room. The Queen of Hearts, who is she? Since this room is all about love, I want the bed to be the main attraction. The heart-shaped headboard will be custom, sexy, and padded, just like me. On the brick wall, I'm feeling bold and groovy, but we'll keep this mural a little simpler and go wild with hearts everywhere. Let's set the mood with a little sexy pendant lighting and a retro statement love seat. We love an option, and maybe just a touch of shag carpet. The view from the bed will matter in this room, so I'm thinking something really cool on the ceiling. There she is, the Queen of Hearts. Are you in love?
Wow, wait, this looks so good.
Hey, I'm Nick.
I'm Jensen.
And we're Very Gay Paint. So Trixie gave us a ring. She said she's working on this amazing motel and could use our help putting up some murals.
It was a no-brainer.
Yeah, here we are.
It's good, right? Yes.
You guys did this?
Yes, Nicole Byer and I did this, yes.
The whole thing?
The way, well, we started it and then, you know, you guys probably could have done it in half the time as professionals. We were struggling.
We started a mural business on accident at the beginning of the pandemic and kind of tricked everyone into thinking that we're experts at it. Yeah, we are comedians. We just got trapped in our apartment through a quarantine and started painting. And then it's just evolved from that.
Today we're tackling the ceiling.
Easy.
Okay. Have you guys done ceilings before?
Yeah.
Have you seen the Sistine Chapel?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Sorry, do you have notes?
Too gay.
I thought it was a little gay. And that's just me. I don't
ornate.
Know. Yeah. We're on a budget. Paint is the fastest way to, like, do something.
Yes. What I think is going to happen is these same three stripes are just going to come up to the ceiling. They're going to travel straight along here, curve to the right. They're gonna curve back down and land right here.
Oh, so it's just like a toothpaste kind of thing.
Yeah. It's just like a toothpaste kind of thing. And that's the theme of the room, right? I don't have a pencil. Could someone support me by having a pencil for me?
Sorry, that's too much to ask.
I came unprepared. Beautiful, not a pencil. I love the effort, though. I appreciate the hustle. Jensen, pencil?
If we were looking for, what would it look like?
So it's sort of long, wooden.
Okay, okay.
Graphite tip. That's another paintbrush, but really good effort. I appreciate it. Jensen, you're falling behind. Trixie's already shown me two things.
Okay.
I don't want anything from you. Okay. I'm looking for, that's a paint can, but you're really close. Okay. Starts with a P. Pencil. This is a, that's a lighter,
that's a
but
lighter.
You're really, really close.
Oh my God. Okay.
Guys, you're doing amazing. That's a cell phone. Who's got the pencil? Who's gonna bring me a pencil? Somebody's got a pencil. Trixie wins. Two pencils.
Great.
Jensen?
What?
I don't know how you turn those corners like that, but.
You find your spring point, you anchor your string here on the point, and you just let the string lead you. Perfect quarter circle.
A pencil and a string? You guys are really robbing people.
Will you talk to us a little bit about your thought process purchasing, like a business venture that has nothing to do with anything you've done thus far?
Yeah, literally.
Totally new.
Why?
Trixie, the character, like the vibe is perfect for Palm Springs. Campy, 60s, frozen in time.
Yeah.
And I've stayed at pretty much every motel. The more David and I joked about it, the more we were like, oh, and we could do this. That would be really cool. And now, millions of dollars in, it's not a joke anymore.
The custom headboard is well underway. It's taking shape. She is not quite there yet. We gotta get some padding on her. And this is one of those design elements that is so central to the room that I think it's worth the splurge to do something custom.
Oh, work, diva, yeah, oh, serve, honey, oh. Oh, the touch, the feel of real, baby.
Trixie keeps talking about how horny this room is.
She says horny themed, which is an interesting theme. You know, we're professionals.
We have boundaries.
Yeah.
Floor work. Yes.
So Trixie does a billion things. We're not surprised that she's bought a motel. She's a drag queen, she has a music career, she's a DJ, she's appeared on 1 billion television shows.
She's a stand-up comedian.
Right. And you know, this doesn't feel too far from our experience, right? We're muralists, we're comedians, we are apartment renters, we're sons.
So we're not too, you know,
we're
dissimilar
kind of
from Trixie.
Same, yeah. Did you see this branded tape measure? Why don't we have this?
That's so cute.
We could probably sell that thing on eBay for...
Keep an eye out for stuff, because we should steal whatever we can, whatever you can carry.
It's bare bones right now, but if we find anything that we can take with us...
Anything.
We have a lot of room in the trunk, so... Hey!
Hi. Oh, you're supposed to not lift with your back, right?
Oh my God, that's the paint.
I swear to God, when this opens, if I ever come into any of these rooms and see something broken, missing, it's game over on site. I'm gonna taser someone. We really want this whole motel to be an extremely safe space for everyone, but especially the LGBTQIA+ community. As a drag queen, I don't always feel safe at hotels when I'm cross-dressing in an elevator and stuff. I really don't. I bought a motel in the gayest city in America for a reason. Yes, I want to make a little bit of money, but I also want to create a space for people to come here and express themselves however they want. Wig optional, but strongly recommended. Okay, I love myself. I think I'm a very talented person. This would have taken me literally 2 days. It's so clean and so even. I can see why you guys are professional gay painters.
Thank you. Thank you for finally acknowledging it.
Yeah, I think the Sistine Chapel was really onto something when they took a chance on you guys.
Yeah, and it was amazing to get our start at sort of a small little project like that before we moved on to the big leagues like this.
Yeah. It looks beautiful.
I am working on an experiment with the floors. And if my client wants terrazzo, they're gonna get terrazzo. Or something kind of like it.
Danny just blows me away sometimes. I mean, she knows I love terrazzo, and we use it on the counter in the Flamingo Room. But it's gonna be too expensive to do like a whole floor. Most designers would be like, sorry, it's too expensive. Here's a boring, cheap version. But Danny's like, well, why don't we figure out a way to do it cheaper that's cooler? Oh my God.
What?
Did you do this?
Terrazzo.
What?
Yes.
Oh my God, it looks so real. It's amazing.
Isn't it cool? I had
it's
no
so
idea
cute.
It would look this much like real terrazzo.
How did you do this?
So basically what you do is you do first coat, second coat, and while the coat is still a little wet, sort of like chicken feed, you just toss out the plastic fleck and it sticks to the paint. And it kind of just falls in this like perfect pattern. And then you do the epoxy coats on top.
It's so cute. If I've learned anything from doing drag for 15 years, there's always a way to do it cheaper and make it look cooler. And now she's finally thinking like a drag queen.
This is actually our regular paint. This is really a big experiment.
This is like wall paint?
It's concrete paint. I'm gonna be honest, when I pitched this to you, I didn't know if we'd be able to pull it off. I've never seen it used on an interior. This is not something that's normally done, so I think I wanna do custom floor mural faux terrazzo for every single room.
Today is the day the second room is coming together. Just in time for the Trixie Cosmetics photo shoot. I love it. The custom velvet headboard is in the room and it looks amazing.
It does. It was also pretty expensive.
Well, custom is the only way to go sometimes. I mean, how else are you gonna get a lip-shaped love seat like this? The floors stressed us all out, but you gotta admit, they look amazing.
They do. They were also a costly experiment.
For me, lighting is always such a big deal, and these hanging pendants are so retro and such a moment.
Danny's eye for detail like this is impressive. She really knows her stuff.
The hot pink shower is so sexy. Reglazing is such an amazing and affordable way to update this bathroom. And the custom stained glass, we really are like surrounded by hearts.
Worth every penny.